आधा वर्ष है। दोस्तों कैसे हैं आप सब? मेरा नाम गौर शेख है, मैं PSF का वन ऑफ द कोर मेंबर्स में से हूँ। तो लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस क्विकली PSF टू यू। PSF इज प्रोफेशनल्स सॉलिडारिटी फोरम। इट्स एन NGO इन हैदराबाद, अ रजिस्टर्ड NGO विच इज स्ट्राइविंग टू हेल्प द प्रोफेशनल्स कम टुगेदर एंड उनके ओवरऑल वेलबींग के ऊपर काम किया जाता है, उनके स्किल्स के ऊपर, उनके फिजिकल मेंटल वेलबींग के ऊपर एंड ऑल्सो गिविंग बैक टू द सोसाइटी। तो वन ऑफ द वर्टिकल्स वॉट वी हैव इज PEP, पर्सनल एनेबलमेंट प्रोग्राम। उसके अंदर एक प्रोग्राम वी हैव कॉल्ड एज हेरिटेज वॉक। इसके अंदर वी विल टेक पीपल टू सम ऑफ द हेरिटेज साइट्स ऑफ द सिटी सो दैट पीपल नो कि वो किस शहर में रह रहे हैं, उसका बैकग्राउंड क्या है। So today we are going to one of such places in Char Minar. So stay tuned. I'm just waiting for the organizer here. Hamare one of the PSF members, Mustafa Hamiduddin bhai. Once he comes, I'll take you along. So pure vlog mein bane rahiye and we'll have a lot of fun. Thank you.
Mustafa bhai has come. Mustafa bhai, just say hi. Let's go.
Mustafa bhai, can you brief? Drive karte karte, what are we going to do today?
Inshallah, we'll have a walk from Badshahi Ashur Khana, which is near to Madina building, just opposite to that.
So,
from there, we'll go towards Char Minar. And on the way, we'll see many historical places,
right,
like the Patargatti, and the Gulzar House, and many more historical facts we'll be able to know from Haseeb Jafri.
Right.
He'll be our curator.
So guys, Dr. Haseeb Jafri is our curator. So, bahut interesting tha. Let me introduce Zainab. Waalaikum. Yeah, how was last time's experience?
It was nice.
Right. So kids had a lot of fun. So the thing is, it is very important. Aap jis shahar mein rehte ho, wahan ka आपको बैकग्राउंड पता हो कि वो शहर कैसे बना है। आई मीन हु वर योर अबा उस्ताद, कौन थे यहाँ पे, व्हाट वाज द कल्चर, राइट? सो वन इंटरेस्टिंग व्हिच आई लर्नड फ्रॉम लास्ट टाइम PSF हेरिटेज वॉक वाज दिस आदाब, राइट? द वे ही एक्सप्लेन्ड इट वाज टू गुड। आई मीन पूरा जानने के बाद कि कुतुबशाही फ्रॉम वेयर दे केम, सो एक्चुअली इट वाज इन द कुतुबशाही टॉम्स वी हैड हेरिटेज वॉक। तो ये जानने के बाद कि वो लोग कहाँ से आए, हाउ दैट होल थिंग हैपेंड एंड ऑल, एंड देयर वर मेनी कल्चर्स दैट टाइम। तो लाइक यू कैन नॉट जस्ट गो विद अस्सलाम वालेकुम विद एवरीवन, राइट? सो दे लाइक स्टार्टेड अ न्यू थिंग कॉल्ड आदाब अर्ज़ है, एंड दैट बिकेम वेरी पॉपुलर, एंड आदाब इज नाउ वर्ल्ड वाइज फेमस थिंग, राइट? लाइक थ्रू आउट द ग्लोब पीपल यूज इट। सच ए ब्यूटिफुल कल्चर दे हैव स्टार्टेड। सो क्योंकि इंडिया इज़ अ मिक्स ऑफ कल्चर, वी हैव गंगा जमुना तहजीब, सो जस्ट सी द वे हाउ पीपल कोलैबोरेट। सो या इट्स डेफिनेटली अ ग्रेट थिंग। सो बने रहिए, विल कीप शोइंग यू लॉट ऑफ स्टफ इन दिस ब्लॉग। सो इट्स गोइंग टू वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग।
तेरी हमदो सना पढ़ रहा हूँ, तेरी हमदो सना पढ़ रहा हूँ। खालिक है तू खुदाया, मालिक है तू खुदाया, इकला कुन से तूने सारा जहां बनाया। खालिक है तू खुदाया, मालिक है तू खुदाया, एक लफ्ज कुन से तूने सारा जहां बनाया। खालिक है तू खुदाया, बुलबुल को बेकली दी, खुश दिल कशीदी आबे।
So guys, we just reached, गाड़ी पार्क हो गई है, now we are heading towards मदीना, होटल मदीना, let's see. One more information you just got to know is Salar Jung Museum used to be here before that building. Then from this place it has been shifted. So guys, this is the famous Medina building. One of the oldest hotels known in the whole city. Yeah, the taste bhi kafi, people get to come to taste. See, what a big billboard. Muhammad Yunus Bhai hai, who's the security guard of this Ashur Khana. Kab se hai aap? सज्जाद है सैयद सज्जाद। कब से है साहब आप?
14 साल
से यही है माशाल्लाह। क्या हाइट है आपकी? 40 हाइट है। ओके वेरी गुड। चलो सो गाइस वी आर एंटरिंग द आशुर खाना फॉर द वेरी फर्स्ट टाइम एटलीस्ट फॉर मी। आप शायद देख रहे होंगे वाह व्हाट अ ब्यूटीफुल एंट्रेंस व्हाट अ ब्यूटीफुल एंबियंस। The team has come, just waiting for rest of the people. Mustafa bhai to pehle se cover ho rahe pura. Sara nizam e qudrat wahdat ki lay sunaye sani hai kaun tera yakta hai tu khudaya ik la से तूने सारा जहां बनाया। खालिक है तू खुदाया मालिक है तू खुदाया एक लफ्ज़ कुन से तूने सारा। देयर कम्स आवर क्यूरेटर फाइनली। थोड़ा वेट कराए तो ही मजा है। Assalamu alaikum Haseeb bhai. Guys, this is our Dr. Haseeb Jaffery, curator for the event. Let me take him into the loop. तो आपका आज का
ये लेके फिरना है
लगा के फिरना है आप। देर इज नो एक्सेप्शन। Haseeb bhai, already you know most of the people here.
Sorry, late ho gaye. 10 minutes. Assalamu alaikum bhai. Assalamu alaikum. All PSF group in? Circle. I want all the kids also to be in the circle. Adab, assalamu alaikum, good morning. So, I am Jaffery. Before I start, what I want to know is what was the dream which you saw this month, or what is the dream which you actually imagined which should come true in your life? So just tell me your name and tell me your dream. So we'll start with Kuduri. We'll start with Minaj. Anything.
Or it is a... Give a quarterly kind of a target.
Could be. It could be a live stream. It could be this week's stream also.
ये more than a dream. It is like setting expectations for VK. करते रहो.
Is that a Hyderabadi dream?
Inshallah, you will.
Are you asking something which we already dreamt or we have to dream about?
You dream about it or you have dreamt about it or you want to dream about it.
Okay.
Keep learning. Nice.
My name is Mohammad Ahmad and I'm...
Stay along with me.
My name is Mohammad Ahmad. I want to help people in the many days of my life.
Nice, very pious.
Whatever way. I'm
short dream is to just achieve my numbers in this part.
Do you do power cards?
I'm Anjali. My dream is to discover Hyderabad, which I've just been.
And where were you from? Or where are you from? Chennai.
Nice.
Farooq Hussain, India is lifting World Cup.
Wow. India lifting World Cup, yeah.
My name is Gao Sheikh, sir. I always dream of about me landing myself in Jannat. Inshallah.
I'll skip and come back in the end.
Okay.
Aisha, what's your dream? Aisha is going to tell her dream. Her dream is to hide away from others.
Ah, nice. Nice. Scientist is.
My name is Sobhya. My dream is to become a good person.
Nice.
Hi, this is Maria. My dream is to get my day good by good teaching, but one step at a time.
Hello, my name is Azmat. My dream is to be balanced.
MashaAllah. Barakallah. Wow.
Nice. Tell me your name and tell me your dream. Dream. Nice.
Very nice. Very simple.
Nice. I thought your dream is to become taller than me.
That she should not dream. It will come by itself. Wow, that's awesome.
No dream.
No dream as of now. It'll come tomorrow.
That's the best dream.
As long as I'm there, Allah should keep me fit to eat biryani every day. So. Bakika, we can manage everything else. So let's quickly start. Before I start, thank you and gratitude to waking up so early on Sunday morning and making it here. That itself needs a big round of applause. That all of us on our courage that we woke up and came out. Most people prefer to sleep, and even more thankful to all the parents who could get their kids. It's even more challenging to bring kids. So, I'll do this walk in both English and Hindi. If somebody wants a Telugu translation, can tell me, I will. So, the place where we are standing today is the newer city of Hyderabad. So, when the Kakatiyas lost and the city of Hyderabad was formed, it was formed inside the Golconda Fort. And the fort is a small place at the end of the day. And some point of time, they thought, nahi, we should expand and leave this walls of the fort and make a city, like a proper city. I always compare, in my own comparison, I always compare Hyderabad to what Dubai is today. Or rather, what Antwerp is to Europe. So, Antwerp is a small city in Europe, and it's a hub for diamond merchants. And nowhere close to it, diamond is mined, but it is still today traded in that city. We were at a junction in Hyderabad where the silk routes from Indonesia would come and deliver their goods at the port of Machilipatnam, and from the other side we would have the port of Goa, which would bring in goods from Iran, Iraq and far Europe. And this all would be traded in the center of India, which is Hyderabad. And that's the reason why Hyderabad is called as the city of pearls. Although we are nowhere close to a seashore, we don't grow pearls, but we traded in pearls. And the beauty was Hyderabad is called as the city of pearls because this was the place where pearls were polished, and the artisans in Hyderabad had the art of, they knew how to pierce a pearl without actually cracking it. it's a very difficult. Now you have lasers and all. Like in back in the day, it was a very difficult. It was a very challenging artistic artisanal fact ke to pierce a pearl. What difficult rata pearl ko pierce karna is very difficult. And that's how we get the name of the city called as the City of Pearls. Now because we traded in pearls, we also started trading in a lot of other spices. We started trading in carpets. We started trading in cotton. We started trading in jute. So the Hyderabadi cotton is one of the finest. The jute which we find in Hyderabad is of exemplary quality. And pulses and spices were traded. And that's how we became a central hub for this transaction between East and West. Now, why I'm telling you this is because during the era of Quli Qutub Shah, the fourth Qutub Shahi king, it was decided that now we can't sustain Golconda Fort as a city. It was beaming with people, it was exploding with people, and they said we will have to make a new city outside the fort. And that led to the formation of what we see is the Charminar. And Charminar jab bana, to it was to be made very strategically. Actually, the original idea was to make not this place as the city. Rather, Quli Qutub Shah's father, Ibrahim Quli Qutub Shah, had a different place in mind. He wanted to make the city center as Ibrahim Patnam. If those who are acquainted with the city, if you go towards B.N. Reddy Colony and there you find a Sagar Highway, that place was the place where he said, let's make the city here. Problem was there was no water that side. Then he went on and he said, okay, no, let's make it towards the west of the Golconda Fort. And he started looking at areas of Mokila and where we see the Usman Sagar and all these things. But that also didn't work out because that area was also too rugged, too rocky. And again, water was a problem. Hyderabad has a water shortage from day one. And that's when they started building a lot of dams in Hyderabad and a lot of lakes in Hyderabad. Some records say that Hyderabad had close to 1600 lakes. Some of them were man-made. Most of them were smaller ponds which were rather built to accommodate more water. That's why we have so many lakes in Hyderabad. And now all these lakes are disappearing and we are at the brim of having floods in our city because of this particular reason. Now why I am telling you this story is that when Quli Qutub Shah came, he fought and he thought ke this is a better area because the river flows. So we are standing in a place where the river is flowing. So this is the river which is called as the Musi River. So the Musi flows like this. Musi goes till Vijayawada. It's a 200 kilometer river. Most people think it is some small trench or some nala. It is not. We have seen it become very furious in past 2-3 years when we saw floods. Musi being flooded and being with lot of water. 1908 was very very important. 1908 mein ek flood aaya tha Hyderabad mein, which was devastating. Almost 40-50,000 people lost their life and it was a very devastating flood. And after that flood, we led to the formation of the Usman Sagar Dam and the Himayat Sagar Dam to control that and check the dam water. And that's when the river actually dried out, I would say. But every monsoon we see that Usman Sagar, the Musi River flows. So you have a river flowing here. So this was a very good place. The land was good. But if you observe, it's very difficult to see now, but the plain where we are standing, it is very close to the, this is actually the bank of the river. Jab hum aise jayenge to iska elevation badhega. So on a slightly elevated place is where Charminar is placed. Now even before, so why did we start the walk from here? The reason for that is even before Charminar was made, Badshahi Ashur Khana was made. Now what is an Ashur Khana? We'll get that little later when we step inside. Excuse me. Lekin this was made as a entrance to the city or as the first structure to the city. Qutub Shahi dynasty was a predominantly Shia dynasty. I hope most of us know there are two sects in Islam predominantly, that is the Shias and the Sunnis. The Qutub Shahi dynasty was a Shia dynasty. The third dynasty which came in Hyderabad to rule was the Nizam or Asaf Jahi dynasty. the Asaf Jahi dynasty was a Sunni dynasty. But little later in the Asaf Jahi dynasty also, we see that because the Shias were so predominant in Hyderabad city, that they took in a lot of Shia wives also. So we see a very deep Shia or Shi influence in everything Hyderabadi, whether it is our food, whether it is our joint culture. And there are stark similarities between, it's very difficult to say that this is a Shia thing and this is a Sunni thing, because it's an amalgamation. Whether you take the origins of food like Haleem and biryani and things like that, we have very deep Shia influences. This particular structure was built even before the city's center, which is Charminar, was built. Now remember, I was telling you the story between Machilipatnam and Goa. Goa west pe hai, east pe hai?
West.
Goa kahan hai? West of India mein, east of India mein. West of India mein. Machilipatnam kahan hai? East of India. Tell you one more interesting fact. The first person to give access to Britishers in India was a journal of Ibrahim Quli Qutub Shah. And he was the one who had captured the fort, or fort now what is called, you're from Chennai, you know Fort George, right? So the Fort George was the first fort which was in control of the Qutub Shahi kings. And this particular general of Ibrahim Quli Qutub Shah, his name was Neknam Khan. Neknam Khan had given it on lease to the Britishers. तो ब्रिटिशर्स का जो सब में पहला लीगल होल्डिंग ऑफ लैंड आया था वो फोर्ट जॉर्ज का था, वो इब्राहिम कुली कुतुब शाह ने ही दिया था. एंड दैट वाज इवन बिफोर द सिटी वाज फॉर्म्ड, सिटी ऑफ हैदराबाद वाज फॉर्म्ड. दिस वाज इन लेट 14th सेंचुरी. बाय 15th सेंचुरी वी सॉ द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर प्लेस एंड वी ऑल्सो सॉ द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ चारमीनार. सो रफली अराउंड अभी 412 years ki range mein hai. The city, if you ask me the age of our city, it's around 400 years. Now, this particular road, if I keep walking straight, I will reach the port of Machilipatnam. If I turn around and if I keep walking this way, I would reach the fort of, Goa. So now you know, apna India ka west kidhar hai abhi hum jahan pe thehre hue hain. Where is the west? This is the west. This is the east. So now you know west and east. So what they did was, they made a square. So when we walk now, it's very difficult to identify. So let us imagine that this particular square is Charminar. So we are standing here. We're coming from here. And here you will find the four gates. So there is one arch here. There is one arch there. There is one arch here. And there is one arch here. So this is called as a Spanish cross. It's called as a Spanish cross. Ek cross upar rakke, uske niche hum log aur ek cross dalte hain. It's called as a Spanish cross. Ye dono, ye four arches ke, ye four gateways ke beech mein, there is one house. And that's called as the Gulzar House. And after that, you have the Charminar. Now many people say that Charminar was built because there was a plague. And Quli Qutub Shah had a wish where he said that if the plague goes away from the city, I would build this. But ideally, it was built as an ideal city, mimicking Isfahan from where the Qutub Shahis had come. And it was built on the logic of the descriptions of Jannat which are written. Usko imitate karne ki koshish kare. So whatever descriptions of Jannat is written in the Quran,
Iran.
So whatever descriptions of Jannat are there in Quran, they are trying to mimic it. In fact, if you look at most of the Islamic architecture across the world, all of them try to do the same thing. They try to mimic the descriptions of heaven, which is there. Usko hum log mimic karke, uske upar hum log banate hain. So that's how you have the Gulzar House in between, and you have the four arched gates, and then you have the Charminar. Now, along with that, now you have any city you want to build, the first thing you will build is a wall. So Hyderabad was also a walled city. So there were many gates, there were close to 13 gates in the city, and this was a walled city. None of these, I think only 2 or 3 gates have survived, most of the gates have gone. One gate is the Dabulpura gate which you see, and the rest of the gates you don't see. So there was again a wall, and within the wall this city was developed. Now this city had water because of the access of the river, and the water table was also good because the river is close. So if you dig a well 30 feet 40 feet you would find water. If I go straight, I would reach to a place called as Kohetur, where a beautiful Qutub Shahi palace would once stand. The palace, original palace, was destroyed, and on that particular palace a new palace was built later in later 19th century, which is now called as the Falaknuma Palace, which is one of the most beautiful palaces. It was called as the Jahanuma Palace also. The Qutub Shahi Palace was called as the Jahanuma Palace. Aur wo jo pahad pe bana hua hai, us pahad ka naam tha Kohetur. Now that is also the site where you see the first church in India. One of the earliest churches, which is an Armenian Christian Coptic church, which is there in the vicinities of Jahanuma.
It's still there?
It's still there. Now you have a school which is called as the Boys Town School, which is run by the Montfort brothers of France. So now you have the Kohetur there, you have the river here. So this road was equivalent to what we called as the GT road. Can somebody tell me what a GT road is? Grand Trunk Road. Grand Trunk Road would take somebody from west to east to west, built by the Mughals, big trading route. On similar lines, this road was there. Now if you go straight on this road, you'd find a very beautiful mosque. My advice to all of you is to, maybe we'll plan it next time, to do the walk of a beautiful mosque called as the Toli Mosque. Toli means tall. It was a tall gate. So that's how we get the locality called as Toli Choki. Tall kiske liye tha? If you want to trade inside the compound of Golconda Fort, you should pay that toll. It was the entrance fees. Uska collection jo aaya aur uska jo profit jo aaya, with that they had built a very beautiful mosque which was called as the Toli Masjid. The purpose of building the mosque was to build the sarai, which is to stay outside the city, and that's how you have the Toli Mosque. There's a beautiful whiff of Nahari in the air. Am I only smelling it or it's there? Very distracting. So, possibly because Nihari ka origin bhi waise hi hai. Now, thank you so much. So, we come to this particular structure, the Badshahi Ashurkhana. I know most of you are sinner here, so I will have to introduce you to Shiism. Before I introduce, my always word of advice to especially young people and those people who want to learn history is to, when you read history, when you hear history, please don't make judgments. You don't read history to say ke uno sahi the aur uno galat the. You should read history as it is, and you should leave your judgments to your own self. Aap judge kar lo, apne aap mein kar lo. You don't have to disclose your judgment. Pehle to judge mat karo, agar khal le rahe to do it in your mind. You don't have to throw your judgments to others, especially in context of religion, and especially in context to, because we don't know the truth. The only thing which we can do with history is you can try to understand the problem, but it's very difficult to do even that. You can't even understand a problem which was 20 years back or what led to the consequences of that problem. So you're trying to understand which was some 600 years back, 800 years back, 400 years back. Very difficult to comprehend. Now, I'll start with this particular structure which is there. The gate has stood test of time for 400 years. Now, you see the golden insignia on that, golden color ka insignia dikh raha hai. Can somebody count how many leaves are coming out of it? 5. Now this is a very beautiful insignia which represents the alam of the Shi faith. Now what is an alam? Now alam is as old as human civilization is, because whenever any caravan would walk, they would carry a pole with them. It's basically a flag post. Because aap dur se kisi ko batana chahte ke we are walking. And in this particular thing, this salam comes to Imam Abbas, where Hazrat Abbas was carrying the alam during the war on the holy month of Muharram. And he was the, it's like how you do this march pass in school. So head girl kya, head boy kya karta hai? Samne thehrta hai. Aur kya karta hai wo? Ek float, ek flag pakadta hai. He holds a flag and he walks. So he is given that charge of holding the flag. So in war also, they do that. I'll not go into the depth of the description of war and what happened on the fight or the war on the Muharram. But it was 4 days. It was a smaller army against a larger army of Yazid, and people were running out of water. So what Hazrat Abbas did was he held this pole and he had this insignia with a hand in front of it. So it is this hand. What does an open hand represent?
Congress.
Congress, yes, of course.
Wait, stop.
Wait or stop. Bye-bye. Okay.
Calm.
Calmness.
Peace.
Peace. So it could mean a lot of things. Now imagine if somebody tells you a hand like this in a war. Then?
Stop.
In war, nobody can come to a war without a weapon. If you show your right hand like this, that means there is no weapon. You want peace. And beneath this hand, there's an old Arab water bag which is called as a chagal. Chagal is basically camel stomach which is stitched to hold water. So what Hazrat Abbas did was he put up this alam and he put up this empty canister or empty bag of water and he was showing this, saying ke, don't attack us and give us some water and we are unarmed.
Later on, the Shi faith also says ke these 5 arches which you say
is Allah, Prophet Muhammad, Hazrat Ali, Fatima, Imam and Hussain. So they say ke these 5 are the first family of Islam. And that's how also you get that name. And that's why it is called as Alam Bardar, because that is what Alam represents. Now most of us have seen either in movies or on streets that during the month of Muharram, there's a lot of mourning in the Shia community and they do a Azadari. What is an Azadari? Azadari is an expression of sadness. So they are still so touched with what had happened on that day of massacre on 10th Muharram that they remember that and they still weep in that pain. It's something like what our Hindu brothers, they repeatedly read the Mahabharata and still find places of pain in the war of Mahabharata. You find the same thing happening in Ramayana and you find the same thing happening in a lot of other religions also. Now, if you read religions in different parts, you find that there is always learning in religion which happens through a pain. So pain is that human emotion which is taken through which religion is explained. And I find this common trait in most of the religions, that there is always a war and there is a pain and there is a tyrant and there is a winner. And then through that pain, you try to give the philosophy of life. The same thing has happened in Islam also. When we walk inside, this place is a place which is one of the oldest Imambaras in India and rather the world also, I would say. And it could be called as an Imambara. It could also be called as a place of Azadari. It is also a place where the Shias would meet and they would display their affection and love for the Ahlul Bayt, which is the first family of Islam. And they still remember that day where all these sad and sorrow things that happened. So for them, the whole concept of Islam lies on the love of Ahlul Bayt. I would not be able to solve your fiqh problems ki ye sahi hai ya galat hai. I'm not the person for it.
But what I would tell you is to look at it
very subjectively and objectively as to what it is, because it is part of our culture and it is part of our heritage. So what you see here is the structure. Obviously, all Imambaras face the Qibla like any other masjid. This is not a masjid, but it is used by the Shias to offer namaz also, but not in congregation.
So obviously the Qibla is there. The Jali work which you see is a later addition during Mehbub Pasha's time, who was the fifth Nizam. You'll have to come closer then.
Let's walk inside. But before we walk inside, I want you to count the pillars. How many are there?
Six.
So, six pillars. And if you look at the stucco work on the top, because it's Persian in its style, you'll not find any animal motifs. You'll not find animal motifs. You'll not find any animal motifs. And you'll always find that the arches which are there are in sets of usually 5, 7, 12, representing the 12 imams which are there. The structure behind us which is there was a later addition built by Mehbub Ali Pasha, and the structures which are towards the right are Langar Khanas which were built by Usman Ali Pasha.
What does
Langar mean? Langar means to serve food. That's called as a Langar. So we'll walk inside. We'll walk inside and we'll sit for 2-3 minutes, and then I'll tell you what all structures you should watch out inside.